Welcome back to Crack the QR series with me, Kavyathan. Today we'll see about the continuation of medical entomology. This is part 3B, the mosquito control measures. If you have not subscribed our channel, do subscribe for more interesting videos like this, and as well press the bell icon so that you will receive a daily video notification. The content of the video are designed in flowchart and as well diagrams to make it more easier. A primary aim in mosquito control is basically this mosquito is making nuisance, it creates disturbance, and as well it is acting as a vector and transferring many deadly diseases. The list of the diseases it is transferring and the breeding sites, habits are discussed in previous video, and the video link is given in the description to watch out. First, for the life cycle of this mosquito, it needs water. Based on the water types, that is a fresh water, artificial collected water and dirty water, different types of mosquitoes breed in that water. First, in controlling, we must break the life cycle of this mosquito and as well to prevent the mosquito bite. The methods here are: one, adult mosquito is going to lay eggs in the water that larvate. So first is the anti-larval measure. Next, from that larva the pupa develops, and from the pupa the mosquito develops. So anti-adult measures, and then the adult mosquito should not bite us, so protection against mosquitoes. Next is the anti-larval measure. Basically the same story comes: water is collected, mosquitoes are breeding, the eggs which is in that area hatches into the larva turns into pupa, and the adult mosquito emerges from the pupa. Again this life cycle begins, that this adult mosquito will lay the egg. Now where all can we intervene is: one, the source reduction, that is the water is getting collected and the mosquito is breeding. Only there is water collection, the mosquitoes are going to breed. So reduce the water collection, that is source reduction. Based on the source of water collected, the different types of water, different types of mosquitoes are going to breed. So first is source reduction. And the next is, mosquitoes have already bred the eggs in the water. Now it is going to form larva. Anti-larval measure is the second measure by chemical control. What are we going to do is, larva is going to present on the surface and as well underwater. They use the siphon tube to breathe, except the Anopheles, which doesn't have siphon tube. One thing, we are going to pour the mineral oil here, and the mineral oil will interfere with the surface and thereby prevents the oxygen supply to the larva, in turn causing larvicidal action. And next is the Paris green. Paris green or copper acetoacinate, it is emerald green. Basically this Paris green is a microcrystalline powder. When we spray put the powder on the water, the surface feeder, that is the Anopheles, is going to die first. But what it's the case of the underwater larva, that is the Pulixin larva, it can be killed with a formulation called the Paris green. Is basically a microcrystalline powder. When it is put over the water, the Anopheles mosquito larva, that is the surface feeder, will be affected. But in case of the underwater, we have already discussed, that is called as a rotary mixer. Rotary mixer is basically 2 kg Paris green plus 98 kg of slaked lime, or you can use soapstone powder. This soapstone powder or slaked lime is acting as a diluent for this, and in turn this is causing the larvicidal action. Next on the list is the synthetic insecticides. Synthetic insecticides, especially Abate, Fentayon, are most effective against larvicides, especially Abate. When we use Abate, it is a concentration of not more than 1 ppm, which we have discussed in previous video also. At last is the biological control. In biological control, the larvae are fed by the fish such as the Gambusia affinis and Lebister reticulatus. This Lebister reticulatus is also called as Barbados melens. These two fishes will feed on the larva, thereby it kills the larva. Next we come to anti-adult measure.
one important thing is we are going to use spray. One is the residual spray and the space spray. In residual spray, the most important against the adult is DDT. Adult has D, so ADU. So take this D out. It is DDT is most effective against mosquitoes. This DDT is given at the concentration of 1 to 2 gram per meter square, 1 to 3 times per year on the walls and as well the places where all the mosquitoes going to take rest. Next is space spraying. In space spraying, we have discussed in previous video also the natural insecticide, that is the pyrethrum, it is most effective for space spray. That is of 1 ounce per 1000 cubic feet. It contains around 0.1% of the active material, that is pyrethrin, in that 1 ounce. Next is malathion or phenytrion is used for a residual ultra low volume spray and fogging. The one larvicide we have discussed in previous slide is the Paris green, that is given at a concentration of 1 kg per hectare of water. Next is protection from mosquito bite. Very simple. One is the screening building. Next is the mosquito net and the repellent. Screening building with a copper or bronze gauze, 16 meshes, and the aperture should be not larger than 0.0475 inches. This holds good for the mosquito net also. The aperture is same, not larger or greater than 0.0475 inches. In case of a mosquito net, it should be ideally a rectangular shape, and in 1 square inch there should be at least or usually 150 holes. When it comes to repellent, the most efficient repellent is diethyl toluamide, specially against Culex fatigans. There are other repellents also used, but one thing with repellent is it is short duration of action. To summarize, in anti-larval measure, we do source reduction of the water, then mineral oil, Paris green we use, abate, and phenytrion like synthetic insecticides, and then biological control by Gambusia fish and Labister fish. Next is anti-adult measure. One is space spraying and residual spraying. In residual spraying, there is DDT. If space spraying, the natural insecticide, that is the pyrethrum, is used. Next one, protection from mosquito bite. It is the screening buildings, but the screening building is costly only. Mosquito nets and repellents are used. Thank you so much for your patient listening.